Cameraman 1.
2.
3.
4.
5.
6. Living in Texas, for the most part, I would say, is pretty peaceful. We occasionally get struck by a hurricane, our weather is a tad warm, and we get thunderstorms from time to time. But I would still like to say that Texas is still very lucky. We've never had to deal with a major earthquake or any of its after effects. The effects of an earthquake are almost always catastrophic. The Republic of Haiti was recently involved in a major earthquake that caused much devastation to the Haitian people. Throughout this speech, you are going to learn about the Haiti earthquake, the earthquake's aftermath, and the relief teams that are going towards Haiti. The Haiti earthquake took place on Tuesday, January 12, 2010. It happened at approximately 4:53 p.m., and it only lasted for about 35 seconds. The earthquake hit in a town called Léogâne, which is exactly 16 miles outside of the nation's capital. Here's an illustration of where the earthquake hit, if you do not know what Haiti looks like. It's on the panhandle. For those who do not know what an earthquake is the shaking movement of the Earth's crust due to tectonic plates moving underneath. These tectonic plates move because of volcanic activity underneath the Earth's surface. The Earth's magnitude is the mathematical measure of the strength based on the maximum amplitude of the seismic waves. When two tectonic plates collide against each other, which cause the earthquake, they produce seismic waves. This particular magnitude was 7.0. We would compare this to a Category 5 hurricane, which is something we're all familiar with. This particular earthquake spawned off 52 aftershocks, measuring of at least 4.5 magnitudes. That, for example, that's like getting hit with an initial Category 5 hurricane and then getting hit 52 consecutive times in a row by a Category 3 hurricane. Earthquake experts called this the strongest earthquake they'd seen since 1770. The Haiti earthquake aftermath was complete devastation. Over 3 million people were affected due to this earthquake. The Haitian government calculated over 250,000 people died due to the initial earthquake. This death toll is expected to rise by the numbers as they uncover bodies under the debris. On January 22, 2010, just 10 short days after the initial earthquake, the Haitian government called out the search for survivors. The Haitian people are uncovering bodies daily. Over 300,000 people were injured due to this earthquake. Buildings collapsed everywhere, and then there was so much debris that people couldn't escape it. Over 1 million people were homeless due to this earthquake. Over 250 plus residences were severely damaged or collapsed completely because they weren't structurally safe or built correctly. Over 30,000 commercial buildings collapsed and were damaged as well. These commercial buildings included transport facilities such as airports and boat ship ports. They also included hospitals, electrical networks, jailhouses, and many schools. The relief for Haiti is still very much needed. Countries that are putting together relief support are the United States, Taiwan, Britain, Venezuela, Mexico, and many other countries. We are trying our best to supply enough food and water, temporary shelter, medical supplies, and supplies that are needed for everyday life. However, there's not enough to go around. Transportation to and from Haiti during the earthquake were almost non-existent. The roads broke in half just like you would a piece of chalk. The supplies that were needed for the people weren't getting to them because no one could transport the supplies that they needed. There's so much destruction and so many dead bodies that people are having to bury their loved ones in mass graves. That's at least 100 people to one grave. They have also been reported to dump bodies inside of old refrigerators and inside trunks of cars because there's not enough space to bury all their loved ones. We need to send as much help as we can to Haiti because they really do need it. I know the American Red Cross is donating all their funds to the Haiti people. The American Red Cross has raised over $100 million. This money is going towards cleanup crews to clean away all the debris. They're going towards medical supplies, food, water, shelter, and things like that. I know the American people have raised over $500 million, but that's really nothing compared to the billions of dollars that happen in destruction. I found this information at earthquake.usgs.gov if you would like to look at some more information. I also went to www.cnn.com/2010/world/Haiti Relief. I also went to philanthropy.com/article/donations to aid Haiti. In conclusion, we learned about the earthquake that hit Haiti, we learned of the earthquake's aftermath, and we learned of the relief that took place for Haiti. Haiti's earthquake was a humbling experience for most people. The country was already in ruins and a poverty-stricken country, and they really couldn't afford this obstacle. So we really do need to come together and help this country. Here are some pictures of before and after. Here's the presidential palace that collapsed. This is just some of the town. Here's some people walking around. That's just a structural building that collapsed. Here's people that were homeless the night of the thing. There's people being pulled out of the debris. This woman is halfway underneath a house that fell down. They're pulling out dead bodies in this picture. This is the supplies that they couldn't get to Haiti. And there's just some workers pulling out people from the relief. Does anybody have any questions?
Why did the earthquake happen?
The earthquake happened, well, it's just Mother Nature. And Haiti sits on top of two tectonic plates that are constantly moving back and forth. They have earthquakes all the time, but they're so mild they don't notice them. So it was evident that this was going to happen eventually.
Why did the government stop searching for survivors just 10 days?
After 10 days, they figured that so many people just weren't going to survive after 10 days of being under debris. No food, no water, so they just stopped the search and got everybody that was searching for them to start cleaning up. They needed cleanup crews more than they needed people to find survivors, I guess.
Why didn't people just leave the country?
Haiti's a very poverty-stricken country, and they don't have the funds to just up and leave like Americans would if, you know, we were to get hit by an earthquake like that. So that's why. Are there any more questions? Okay, thank you, guys.